This time, I'll call the Budget Committee meeting to order and ask Angeli to call the roll, please.
Cole. Ham.
Here.
Lewis.
Here.
Mitchell.
Here.
Here.
Would you please make the emergency announcement?
Before we get started, let me read the emergency evacuation procedures. In the event of an emergency evacuation, an alarm will sound. Everyone should exit the building by way of the nearest stairwell in a safe and effective manner. If the nearest stairwell is blocked by smoke, use the other stairwell. Do not use the elevator. Once you have reached the main floor, follow the exit signs to exit the building and quickly proceed away from the building. Please be mindful of others evacuating and of emergency vehicles.
Now I'll ask if there's any public input on items on the agenda. Yes, come up.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Tawny Monroe, District 7. Item E1F, the IT committee didn't approve these expenditures slash recommendations. They simply forwarded this on. Furthermore, this request appears to be for everything. Perhaps we should send it back to the IT committee to try to prioritize, because this is a lot of money to spend all at once. Page 39 lists desktop monitors as costing $168.30 each, but I did a quick search online and could find them for a lot less. It's possible that the same thing is true for PCs, but without the known specs, I couldn't do an exact comparison. So I would ask that this be sent back to the IT to prioritize. The memo from the finance director says sheriff's office at the top, but it's from the finance director to the budget committee. So I hope that that could be clarified what that means exactly. Paragraph 3 in that letter says, in the course of presenting the net 3 recommendations to the IT committee, questions arose about including the Blount County Sheriff's Office needs. The IT assessment does not include those needs. However, this budget request incorporates those needs consistent with the net 3 recommendations. I have heard that money has been set aside for the construction or expansion of the jail. So what I would like to know is, has $1 million been escrowed and earmarked to expand or construct a new jail? And is there a plan to set aside $1 million more? Thank you.
Anyone else on items on the agenda? Seeing none, item D, minutes. The minutes that need approval are in your packet, and they are from November the 9th. Have a motion and a second. Any discussion? I'll ask for a voice vote. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? I'll declare the motion passed. Item E, finance increase, decrease, and transfers. E1A, General County Recovery Court, $3,658. Funds from SAMHSA grant out of Morgan County. Do I hear a motion to put it on the floor?
Move to send it forward.
Have a motion. Do I have a second?
Second.
Is there any questions or discussion on those? Seeing none, I'll ask for a roll call vote, please.
Cole.
Yes.
Hannum.
Yes.
Lewis.
Yes.
Mitchell.
Yes.
Moon.
Yes.
Motion passes.
Item E1B, library. $25,700 to put them in line with the Evergreen study. Do I have a motion to go ahead and get this on the floor? Pass it on.
So moved, Mr. Chairman.
Have a motion. Do I have a second?
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Do I have any questions or discussions?
Somebody could just explain.
Randy, will you explain what that?
The reason this one is being presented now is that the last meeting, when we brought all the other departments, the board had not acted on this one, and we didn't want to get in front of the board, so the board has now acted. The recommendation here is the same as the others. This is as a result of the full implementation of Evergreen, including all appeals for the library. And we're paying for this out of fund balance. And then the cost will ultimately be shared by all three governments. But we account for the full activity of the library here at the county.
Any other questions or discussion? I'll ask for roll call vote, please.
Cole.
Yes.
Hannum.
Yes.
Lewis.
Yes.
Mitchell.
Yes.
Moon.
Yes.
Motion passes.
Item E1C, this is schools, $10,000 for the grant from the State Departments of Education for the LEIA leader models. Do I have a motion to go ahead and get this on the floor? Have a motion. Do I have a second?
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Open for discussion or questions. Does anyone have any questions or discussion? I think Troy is here. If you have any questions for Troy.
It's a flow through, isn't it?
This is a flow through grant. Yes.
I would just like, Mr. Chair, if I could ask a little bit of clarification for what exactly does LEA mean? I think I understand, but I want to make sure.
Troy, would you come up, please?
LEA stands for Local Education Agency. So it's the state's terminology for each school district in the state.
It's a school
system. It's a school system, yes. The LEA is just the state's acronym for any school system in the state. Maryville City Schools is an LEA, or a local education agency. Blount County Schools is a local education agency.
Let me rephrase.
Okay.
Leader models. You have leader models currently that you're following, you're developing. This is part of what you're doing, is developing some leader models. I'm trying to follow what you're doing.
Okay. The grant goal or description is was a non-competitive open invitation to all school systems in the state. I think there were 14 that applied. They awarded to all 14. It's a statewide teacher leader network design team, which will be used to create teacher leader models that all LEAs or all school systems in the state of Tennessee could use at the end of the project. So they've got 14 school systems participating.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
So this is for the teacher leader. This is a grant for the teachers, actually.
Well, it's for we are to identify four highly effective participants selected by the director of schools to comprise our specific district team. Each team of four has to be comprised of an instructional supervisor, an instructional coach, an assistant principal, and a teacher leader. So four members would come from that group.
If I understood what I read correctly, they've already been selected and you've had two meetings already, correct? One today is?
The dates of the meetings were November 17 and 18, and there is a meeting today, yes.
Thank you.
Any other questions on this? Seeing none, I'll ask for a roll call vote, please.
Cole.
Yes.
Hannum.
Yes.
Lewis.
Yes.
Mitchell.
Abstain.
Moon.
Yes.
Motion passes.
Item E1D, CSX reimbursement. Randy, before, go ahead.
Mr. Chairman, I move that we send Blount County Sheriff's Office Purchasing Animal Center Development Emergency Management Schools with CSX reimbursements forward.
Randy, can that motion go on as it's presented?
Sure, I mean, we can.
Yes, we can just incorporate each of these individually into the motion. Okay. This is for the reimbursement for all the departments that we invoice CSX for time incurred by Blount County or costs incurred by Blount County. And we've already received the money, by the way.
This is to recognize the revenue, is that correct?
No, this is to recognize the fact that we received the revenue and now we need to reimburse these departments
okay.
for the costs they incurred back okay. in July.
Okay, I have had a motion and a second. Any other questions or discussion on this? I'll ask for roll call vote, please.
Cole?
Yes.
Hannum?
Yes.
Lewis?
Yes.
Mitchell?
Yes.
Moon?
Yes.
Motion passes.
Item E1E, General County Reappraisal Program, $35,000. You have a motion to go ahead and get this on the floor. Have a motion. I have a second. I'll now ask Randy and Angeli if you will explain this, please.
Okay, and Tim Helton also included a memo, but when he did his budgeting for this year, he only budgeted benefits for 3 out of his 6 employees. So we forecast monthly to kind of see where how we're tracking based on the budget, and we can see that he's going to be significantly short in benefits, and so this amendment is to increase his budget to cover the 3 employees he mistakenly left out.
Okay, any other questions or discussion on that? Tom?
Thank you. I was wondering if Tim could let us know, is there any possibility that this money could be recovered in other reduction of expenses? I don't know the total budget of his department, but.
In this particular department, no. And that's why he had to bring it forth as an increase, because he didn't have any money he could transfer from other lines in that particular department to cover it, because it's a $35,000 shortfall, and he didn't have that anywhere to cover.
Did he have a reason that he couldn't be here tonight?
Yes, he said he had a death in the family.
Okay. All right, any other questions or discussion? I'll ask for roll call vote, please.
Cole?
Yes.
Hannum?
Yes.
Lewis?
Yes.
Mitchell?
Yes.
Moon?
Yes.
Motion passes.
Item E1F, General County Capital Projects, $1,348,942 IT Infrastructure Network. Do I have a motion to get it on the floor?
So moved, Mr. Chairman.
Have a motion. Do I have a second? Have a motion and a second. Now I ask for any discussion or questions. Commissioner?
I've already talked with Randy a little bit about this, but I wondered if, just for everyone here, if Randy, you could explain a little bit more.
The recommendation is that we ended last year with approximately $10.7 million total fund balance, and about $6.7 million, I think it was, unassigned, unencumbered fund balance. As you know from the needs assessment that you were forwarded that went to the IT committee, we've got some pretty significant issues that we need to deal with in putting a new backbone network into the county. We have asked the Sheriff's Department to provide us their needs. We addressed some of the needs, but not the PC needs. So what we wanted to do is bring a recommendation to you in the form of an order of magnitude. This can be refined on unit costs and things like that when it comes time to bid out the different components. But we felt it was very important that we at least make a commitment that we're going to invest in fixing the network, because the next step is to do an RFQ, request for qualifications, for a firm to come in here and actually implement this recommendation. And we feel it's imperative that we make the commitment financially to fund the project so that we can get some serious responses to the request for qualifications that the county's going to move forward and make the necessary investment. It's going to be a, as I recall, it's a 12 to 18 to 2 year investment. We've estimated about a year's worth of costs here, assuming we can accelerate some of this. But the county's got some very significant exposure here if we don't make this type of an investment, in my opinion.
Just one follow-up question. For the fund balance, I think there's kind of a guideline, or not necessarily a rule, but I don't know the terminology, but there's an amount of money that we want to keep in the fund balance per our guideline. Where are we compared to that?
Well, the guidance we've been given is somewhere around 15%. And we feel like we're in very good shape. We ended up last year about $3 million better than we expected. And that's primarily, we'll discuss here in a little bit, we'll discuss some of the reasons for that, but we had some revenues that came in higher than budgeted.
And so by allocating this 1.3 to the IT infrastructure, it shouldn't jeopardize, it sounds like, our guideline or where we want to be on fund balance.
No, sir.
Thank you.
Any other questions or discussion? I'll ask for roll call vote, please.
Cole.
Yes.
Hannum.
Yes.
Lewis.
Yes.
Mitchell.
Yes.
Moon.
Yes.
Motion passes.
Item E1G, workers' comp, general county, $319,563 surcharge in sheriff's office, and $259,048 surcharge due to the schools for underfunding. Before we go any further, would y'all like to discuss that, what that is exactly? Randy?
Well, we've incorporated a memo here that kind of outlines the two. We put a, in our, you know, we're required at the beginning of the year to put the parameters in for all of our insurance and benefit programs, and we got that out to all the departments. And then we failed to include in account 51900 the full accounting for that for the county. Technically, we're asking that you appropriate fund balance to make this work. In the final analysis, I don't think we'll use any fund balance to actually pay for it, in my opinion. But we've got to have a balanced transaction, revenues and expenses. And this applies to general county and also the schools. And this bills, this ends up going in to both in from both sources, from the schools and from general county, will end up going into our workers' comp fund and build our reserves. Or improve our reserves, I should say.
Do I have a motion to send this on?
Move that we send general county and schools work.
Have a motion. Do I have a second? And a second. Any other discussion or questions?
Randy. in order for our reserves to be where they should be, it's not really an option whether to not fund this, is it?
No, it's not an option. We could end up not getting approved by the state to continue what we've been doing. The difficulty is, and frankly, it's embarrassing to have to tell you we made a mistake, but when you're dealing with an antiquated system like we are, things fall through the cracks. And that's not an excuse. It's what happens when you're trying to get stuff done at the last minute, and then nothing we have in our accounting system is that integrated.
Any other questions or discussion?
Randy, on these two items, whose responsibility is it to estimate those premiums or to set those amounts?
Well, that comes from risk management, the estimates, and they got all that to us, and we got it in all the instructions that actually went out to all the departments. We just didn't budget for that piece of it in 51900, which is other general administrative.
Any other questions or discussion? Seeing none, I'll ask for roll call vote, please.
Cole?
Yes.
Hannum?
Yes.
Lewis?
Yes.
Mitchell?
Yes.
Moon?
Yes.
Motion passes.
Now moving on to decreases. E2A, General County Civil Defense, which is emergency management, $55,700. What they did here was accidentally included a grant figure twice in their budget. Am I correct, Randy?
Yes.
Angelique?
Yes.
Okay. I'll ask for a motion to send this on.
So moved.
Have a second? Have a motion and a second. Any other discussion or questions? I'll ask for roll call vote, please.
Cole? Hannum?
Yes.
Lewis?
Yes.
Mitchell?
Yes.
Moon?
Yes.
Motion passes.
Item E2B, General County Animal Center, $11,912.21 to reconcile the county account to match SMAC F, his contract with Memorandum of Understanding. Do I have a motion to get this on the floor?
Moon.
Have a motion and a second. Any questions or discussion? Angelique, will you explain what happened here?
Yes.
Bless you.
This is actually a correction from last month. In SMACF's MOU, it says that they allocate $180,400 a year. If any money is additional on top of that at the end of the year, it has to go back into the SMACF budget. It can't roll back into general fund. So last month, we basically increased their budget by this overage, and we shouldn't have done that, because if you read further in the MOU, and I've attached kind of what we went by last month, but if you read further, they detail it, they pay less. The next quarter, they reduce their payment by whatever they overpaid in the previous year. So this is just to get their budget back down to $180,400, because we inadvertently increased it by the $11,900.
Okay, do I have them? Any other questions or discussion? I'll ask for roll call vote, please.
Cole?
Yes.
Hannum?
Yes.
Lewis?
Yes.
Mitchell?
Yes.
Moon?
Yes.
Motion passes.
Now we're moving on to transfers. E3A, General County Elections, $6,000. Election commissioners increase. Let's get a motion to put it on the floor, and then I'll ask Susan Hughes to come up and explain this.
I move we send it forward.
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Any other discussion before we ask Susan to come up?
If yes. I understand this correctly, Mr. Chairman, it's $100 a month increase for each one of the election commissioners.
Susan, will you come up and explain exactly, is that correct? Is that what this is?
That's correct. They've asked for an increase of $100 a month. I don't know how long ago it was that they had an increase last, but it's been a long time.
2007.
Oh, thank you.
What do the commissioner, election commissioners, what are they paid a month?
$300 for the members and $400 for the chair.
Okay. And how often do they meet?
Once a month. And then if they're, you know, during an election year, they can be called in for a variety of things. They'll be very busy next year.
Okay.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes.
Have they not had other meetings this last year because of, one, your job change? Two, I think Amendment 1, there's activity at the state level on it that's required other meetings. So there's other meetings during the year other than the regular meeting outside of the election cycle.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Any other questions or discussion? Commissioner Cole.
Where does the money for their salaries, is that state money or county money?
County. What's the, and I don't know, I guess if you did a comparison with other counties our size, what kind of pay do those commission, those election commissioners, what do they get? What do
just
they?
Just depends on the size of the county. I think we're like, as far as registered voters, we're like the fifth largest in the state. And of course, some of the larger ones pay a whole lot more. So it's just hard to, I guess I should have brought more documentation.
Okay, go ahead.
One more question is, how are these commissioners appointed, or how are they put into these positions?
The State Election Commission appoints them based on recommendations made by each party.
Is there any other questions or discussion?
Mr. Chairman?
Yes.
If this goes forward, if I read the statute correctly, require a resolution of the county legislative body stating the amount, the monthly amount. If there again, if I read the statute correctly. So if we send this forward, either accounting or the commission one will have to draft a resolution resolving that it be X amount per month.
Okay.
I just want to make sure that's clear. Okay. We can't do it by just voice vote. Thank you.
Commissioner Cole.
Based on the board's recommendation to give them this increase, what if we don't approve it tonight? Can we bring it back for the next budget cycle and include it in the budget at that time? Because right now we're going to have to come back and do a appropriation or adjustment, right, if we approve this?
It's a transfer from temporary personnel.
So you're covering all of this in your budget itself?
Yes.
Okay. Any other questions or discussion? I'll ask for roll call vote. Thank you, Susan.
Cole?
Yes.
Hannum?
No.
Lewis?
Yes.
Mitchell?
Yes.
Moon?
Yes.
Motion passes.
Item E3B, debt service, $11,635.01. Expense budgeted as principal, should have been interest. Let's have a motion to get it on the floor.
So moved.
Have a motion to get it on the floor. Do I have a second? Have a motion and a second. Now, is there any discussion or questions? Randy, will you explain exactly what this is?
Yes, we have a principal account and an interest account. We budgeted it in the wrong account. no increase in the budget whatsoever. It's just, it's all in the debt service fund. The total's correct. We just put it in the wrong detail account.
Is there any questions? Commissioner?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Randy, is any of this a result of the audit being closed out this month and basically making adjusting entries, or am I off base there?
Technically, they're not adjusting entries, but obviously it's things that we've recognized as part of doing our monthly close is where we find it. And that's one of the benefits of doing a monthly close.
Any other questions? I'll ask for a roll call vote, please.
Cole. Hannum.
Yes.
Lewis.
Yes.
Mitchell.
Yes.
Moon.
Yes.
Motion passes.
Item E3C, General County, $500,000 positive mid-year adjustment to forecast. I have a motion. Let's get it on the floor for questions. Do I have a motion? Have a motion. Do I have a second? Have a motion and a second. Angelique, will you present this, please, what this is?
Yes. Now that we're several months, almost halfway through the year, again, we do our monthly forecast to see how we're trending and how we're matching up to budget. And there were several revenue accounts. There were a few where there was no revenue budgeted, but we've gotten money in. There were others where it looks like we're not going to make the amount that we've budgeted. So it's basically just a mid-year adjustment based on forecast.
Do I have anyone that has any questions or discussion? Michael.
Because these are different departments that money is going to, are those the same departments that had the either overages or were under accounted for revenues? Is that why those adjustments are like they are? On each of those account numbers?
Well, the ones at the top that total $800,000 are those accounts that we believe we are due. We will recognize $800,000 more in revenue than we budgeted. The ones below are items that we're going to realize $300,000 less in revenue than we budgeted. So you're seeing those that we're recommending be adjusted upward and those that we recommend adjust downward, and the net gain to the county general fund's $500,000.
And in particular, the shortage of the circuit court clerk, that's quite a bit of
actually,
is there a reason for that, it was that way?
Well, they budgeted $600,000 this year, which was an increase from last year of $200,000. I looked at how it's trending so far this year. They're averaging about $30,000 a month, which shows they'll come in around $360,000, give or take. Last year, they came in at $368,000, and the previous year, $280,000. So I just wanted to get it a little more true to what it's been running.
Was there a particular line item in the circuit court clerk's budget to account for that shortage? Or did they don't bundle all that revenue under one line item, do they?
No. And there were no corresponding appropriation adjustments to these revenue adjustments. Right. Yeah, part of it is a $297,000 settlement from 13-14 that they're still waiting to receive from the state. I think that's why they bumped it up this year.
So they anticipated that already coming in or coming in this year, and it hadn't.
And we still haven't gotten it.
Okay, thank you.
The other thing it's important to understand, part of the reason we're doing this, other than just make sure we've got timely information to you folks, is this will be the building block for what we base our budget on for next year. So part of the effort is we do our monthly closes. They're soft closes, but pretty realistic. And then this is the cumulative effect of what we're seeing now through November for this fiscal year. And this will give us a little truer base for presenting the budget for next year to work off of.
Is there any other discussion or questions? I'll ask for roll call vote, please.
Cole?
Yes.
Hannum?
Yes.
Lewis?
Yes.
Mitchell?
Yes.
Moon?
Yes.
Motion passes.
Item F, discussion and possible action, FA grant, General County Maintenance Department. Randy, you want to explain that?
This is a application that is due next month. And this would replace the remainder, if we're awarded this grant, would replace the remainder of the windows on the 72 building, or 70, the far end. I think there's 120-something windows in that building. And then our understanding is if we are willing to, the more we're willing to commit as a grant match, the greater the likelihood is we would receive the award. So this is the application, and we would have money either from Fund 112, which is the building fund that manages the jail and this building, is what they're tentatively earmarking as our match.
So does this need to come as a recommendation from the Budget Committee?
We need approval to pursue the grant, since we would be spending money if we got awarded the grant. Okay. But then we would come back to this body if we received the award to appropriate the money.
I move that we send it forward with a recommendation to apply for the grant.
Okay. I have a motion on FA to move it forward with the approval to apply for the grant. Do I have a second? Have a motion and a second. I'll now ask for a roll call vote, please.
Cole?
Yes.
Hannum?
Yes.
Lewis?
Yes.
Mitchell?
Yes.
Moon?
Yes.
Motion passes.
Item FB, budget process calendar. You have that on your packet. In front of you. Do I have a motion to send that forward, the recommendation?
So moved.
Have a motion. Do I have a second?
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Is there any discussion or questions on this on the budget calendar that's in front of you? Hearing none, I'll ask for roll call vote on this.
Cole?
Yes.
Hannum?
Yes.
Lewis?
Yes.
Mitchell?
Yes.
Moon?
Yes.
Motion passes.
Item FG, finance reports. This was for information only. I'll now ask if there's any input on items that are not on the agenda. Yes, you can come up.
Karen Miller, District 4. And I'd like to know if this body have any funds or monies that is set aside for the expansion or construction of a new jail. Are any of you aware of this monies, if that is what is happening? And if so, how much? And will be any additional money set aside? Does anybody know, have answers to these questions?
Yes, there has been, there on the books as of June 30, there is about $1.5 million, I think, set aside as an assignment of fund balance.
Okay.
For the purpose of, and what it is the excess fees that were collected from reimbursements. We're setting that aside so that we don't get dependent on that in our operating budget. And then that is available for this body and county commission to do with as they see fit. But that's an assignment only.
It's an assignment only. Okay, thank you for that clarification.
Yes.
Have those funds been earmarked or escrowed for the building of a jail?
No, they're just set aside for public safety. That's the way it shows on the books.
Okay. I'd like to read this body the TCI minutes from the September 2nd meeting. This is the Board of Control minutes. It says, Sheriff James Barong noted that he came in as sheriff in 1989 and inherited a facility that was already overcrowded. He said he is finding out that the building a new facility is the most unpopular expenditure of tax dollars there is, unless you are a victim of a crime, and that they are running into issues with the county commission and legislative issues. Sheriff Barong said that he addressed the board 3 years ago, and at that time said that the mayor did not think he had a problem, but rather the sheriff had a problem. Since that time, the mayor is on board 100% and called the sheriff the previous day and told the sheriff that $1 million had been escrowed and earmarked for a new jail and a plan to do the same thing next year. The sheriff said that they are making great strides and progress with the cooperation between the jail and the mayor's office. He added that they also have a commission that does not believe there's a problem. So our sheriff, apparently, according to the Board of Control minutes, has said that $1 million has been earmarked and escrowed and that there's a plan to do so next year. I want to know why those funds were not used to offset this huge tax increase we just had in June. He said right here, these records say that it's been earmarked, escrowed and earmarked for a new jail and a plan to do the same thing next year. I want to know when the commission was going to be informed and the public was going to be informed about this. I think this is a huge chunk of money. Is this taxpayer money, or were these from court costs, from fees?
The term I used, I was pretty clear. It's an assignment of fund balance predicated on excess fees from reimbursements for jail fees.
Okay, and was that in this year's budget?
No, this is last fiscal year.
Okay, and was that explained to the budget committee and or the commission
when that
was done?
No, it was not.
And why not?
There's no appropriation or budgeting of it. It's judgment on my part as the county's finance director to assign. If it's restricted in any other way, it would be either through state legislation or through an act of this body, being county commission.
So you're saying we have about $1.5 million sitting in that account right now?
There's a total of $1,500,000 and change.
And so the commission was not told and the public has not been told.
The commission can do with that money what it sees fit to do with.
Okay, well, we have a sheriff going to Nashville saying that he has had a conversation with the mayor. And that's in the TCI minutes.
I made the recommendation to the mayor that we set that money aside for the purpose of county commission having it available to address whatever need arises with our overcrowding situation.
Then why wasn't the commission told, and why wasn't that money used to offset this huge tax increase?
We didn't know that at the time that the budget was voted on.
The $1.5 million?
If you have any other discussions with the finance director, his office is downstairs. Make an appointment. Thank you.
All right.
Any other questions or anything, any other input? Seeing none, I hear a motion to adjourn. Move we adjourn.
Second.